supposed to go like in each ear and out the other side. You know what I mean?
All right. Today we're checking out Alice in Chains. This is our first time hearing anything from them. It's been requested a bajillion times. We're starting with the song Love, Hate, Love. Let's get into it.
This next song is about pain. It's called Love, Hate, Love.
Well, we know what it's about. Okay, we need to pause it. We're 2 minutes into the song. We haven't paused it yet. Okay, what you got?
That vocal fry. Oh! It was just so grimy. You know what I mean?
Yeah, can you hear the words?
I wasn't even paying attention to the words.
Oh my goodness.
You told me I'm gonna leave me hanging.
Yeah, that was actually the part that stood out to me the most.
Oh.
Yeah, so I guess his girl's cheating.
Dang.
He says it's a song about pain.
Honestly,
love, hate,
honestly,
love.
Being in love, that kind of pain of like love and loss pain is like the worst.
Yeah.
It's the worst. That's the worst pain. Oh my God.
Right?
It'll have you doing some crazy things, saying some crazy things. Like, That's how you make a good song, though. That's the best songs are the ones where people are talking about heartbreak, in my opinion.
I don't know.
Not necessarily.
But out of pain, you can make some really good art, but I don't know if my favorite songs are about heartbreak.
Not my favorite, but I'm saying the art that's like, that voice is like totally in tune with everything else going on. Like there's no, like technical training doesn't matter. That is like a pain song. You know what I mean? Like when
right,
I hear a song,
right.
It's like, that's like soul and blues to me and like jazz and like that type of energy. That's like the direction it goes a lot of times.
Yeah, I mean, this is crazy. Like his performance too, because he is like in the zone.
He's like enchanting in
he
a way.
He was
like,
on the
like,
microphone.
Yeah.
And his lips were literally like on, you know what I mean? Like
he was singing.
Like on the microphone.
Yeah. Yeah.
It was almost like he was making love to the microphone. It was crazy.
And like I found myself kind of just like really, like it was a little bit like, I don't know, just like captivating, like kind of like eerie and kind of spooky and kind of like just drawing you in, you know?
Yeah.
Woo!
You should have heard.
Oh, man.
I can't hear all the words where you're like, lost inside my sick head. I still love you, but I still burn. Something in between there and this and that. I don't know.
Something what you like, got? Take my hand and fuck you.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
This is definitely heartbreak. You know what I mean? The song.
I'm loving it.
I mean, it's a great performance. And then like, now, like, he's not holding the mic. He's holding the stand. It's just like, it's so intimate. Like, him and the microphone on the stand, it's like they're in a room all by themselves. It's crazy. Right? Like, just the way he's touching it and moving stuff, it's crazy.
There's no...
I feel like he's in the zone, and there's nothing else but him and the microphone and the stand, and he's pouring his heart out.
Like, this isn't staged. This isn't acting. Like, it's not like they said, okay, walk here at this point in the performance, and then walk here at this point.
Oh, yeah, like those kind of things.
Yeah, like, it's totally... It seems like they literally just got on stage and like poured out their hearts.
It's art. I want to look at the lyrics after this.
And the electric guitar is incredible. This guy on the electric guitar is like in his own zone too. Like, he's like ding 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 ding, ding, and then he's like whipping his hair, and like he's not even like paying attention to the scene. He's like just with the guitar. Like, I feel like he's married to the guitar, he's married to the mic stand, you know what I mean? Like, they're literally all just
they
like
they all love their art,
right? Yeah, I feel like technically, okay, so I grew up in theater, so it's like I have a little bit of singing technical understanding, but like they technically don't do it like the way you're supposed to. They'd be like growling and screaming and frying and all kinds of crazy stuff, but it sounds so good. It sounds so good.
Right.
Do that.
I see why they want us to do that version, like that performance. That was crazy.
It's like, I feel like he didn't even, it's like lyrics, what lyrics? Like, it was just kind of like his his heart.
You were too into the performance to listen
to
lyrics.
Like his heart sang. You know what I'm saying? Mm. Like, it just bypassed all the, like, sort of, like, you know, all the stuff, all the distractions, and, like, got to the point.
So how'd you like it overall, before I pull up the lyrics?
Oh, I really liked it. That, to me, felt like, okay, you know the bars on Bourbon Street are, like, a couple streets over, like, in New Orleans, like, on Frenchman Street, you know what I mean? A little tucked off, and then you hear some music and stuff. I feel like they'll play big band music, like, you know, or else they'll play, like, dirty soul music. You know what I mean? And Dirty Soul has a little more electric guitar, a little bit more, you know what I'm saying? It felt like that to me. It felt like smoke in the air, Dirty Soul, in like the corner of New Orleans. That was
the
vibe.
Yeah, it was a, what's the word? Sultry, I guess? Is that the right word? I don't know.
Yeah.
But I don't know. It was just like pure art. Like, dude was really into it. Do you see what I saw with the microphone and stuff? Like, the way he was handling the microphone and the stand and stuff, it was like.
His vocal cords had like a layer of sandpaper on them. Because he was able to just, like, over and over. It seemed like it wasn't damaging his vocals. You know what I mean? It seemed like it didn't hurt. But I feel like that would hurt me.
Yeah, dude could really sing. Wow. There are a lot of songs that are this style. I'm not going to try and classify the genre. I don't know anything about
that stuff. Yeah, just say it how you feel.
But,
it, you know what I'm saying?
You know what I mean? A lot of this style is, like, the singing's not like that.
Right. It's not.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, that to me was, like.
It's like he could have went a cappella.
Right, right. But then it's like that. Oh, I wonder. Now I want to see more from this band because, like, I mean, they're different than what we've seen so far.
Right.
And it had a little bit of, like, old rockness because the electric guitar was a little slower to me. You know what I mean? Like, I feel like Black Sabbath and, like, some of the older bands have, like, a very, like, slow melodic electric guitar. And I feel like this one did, too. But that might just be the song.
Who knows? I like the sound, too.
Wow, we both like
it wasn't blaring. You know, that's my biggest thing, like super high pitched like guitar solos that like pierce my ears and like go into my brain.
Yeah.
Like if I hear something that's too high pitched, it's like two piercing like laser type things going in my ears and then going to the middle of my head and then getting bigger and just gonna explode my head.
Well, see, it's supposed to go like this. It's supposed to go like in each ear and out the other side. You know what I mean? It's supposed to be like.
I hear you, but it doesn't work like that. Like the high pitched sounds and stuff. But this wasn't. It wasn't like that, so I like that.
Yeah, I feel you.
I don't like all the high pitch and blaring and all that. This was like chill.
I feel you. This was beautiful.
The most artistic artists be the ones to go. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But I guess to be able to access that kind of emotion, you probably don't have your emotions under control.
That's true.
You know what I mean?
It like, takes a.
That's depth reaching a level of emotion. Like, yeah, like a depth of emotion that like normal people don't.
You
really.
You don't let yourself go there.
Right.
Yeah. I mean, that's dark. That's a dark place he was in. That song.
You ready to get into the lyrics?
Yeah.
Want to see these lyrics?
Let's do it.
All right, so at the top, the longest song on the Facelift album, and also the darkest, this song talks from the perspective of a sociopath. Did I pull the right thing? Yeah. Love, hate, love, Alice in Chains? What? I thought it was like a breakup song he's talking about. Well, maybe a breakup if you are a sociopath.
Hey, you know.
What? All right, I tried to love you. I thought I could. I tried to own you. I thought I could. I want to peel the skin from your face? I thought he said something about that. I was like, no, I misheard that. There's no way. Before the real you lays to waste? What? While this song is from the perspective of a sociopath, this line is not literal. Okay. In contrast, he wants to preserve his perception of this girl before she revealed her true self, and he can no longer see her the same way. Okay, that's a very artistic way of saying that.
Yeah.
I mean, he's like really knee deep in some art. So, I mean, it doesn't surprise me. Okay, anything else that you want to read? Any parts stand out? You told me I'm the only one. Sweet little angel, you should have a run. Lying, crying, dying to leave. Innocence creates my hell.
I live for you, but I'm not alive. Take my hands before I kill. I still love you, but I still burn. So, I mean, basically, I think sociopath sounds like a really extreme description of it.
But who came up with that? Did he say that? Because, I mean, it was in the top part and it was in that explanation of the lyrics. It's almost like it's a fact that that was how the song came about. Not like, oh, we think it's from the perspective of a sociopath, you know?
Right. Well, either way, I feel like he was in a relatably dark place to, you know, a lot of people going through, like, relationship drama. And it's beautiful.
Okay, check this part. Cheating myself, still, you know more. It would be so easy with the whore. Try to understand me, little girl, my twisted passion to be your world. That's some sociopathic stuff.
Cause
like, he wants to be her world.
But it would be so easy with a whore.
Right.
So, like, basically non-emotional attachment type situation.
What are you saying? Try to understand me. Like, my twisted passion is to be your world. So like, he wants her world to revolve around him. Because I'm not saying he is a sociopath, but he's writing the song from that perspective. You know what I mean? Like, to be your world. That's a little red flaggish. You know what I mean?
Interesting. Okay. Interesting. Mm. Well, you know, we all got our darkness. Thank you for watching this video. Make sure you like the video and comment below any other suggestions you have or your thoughts on the song. Make sure you subscribe to the channel if you're not subscribed already. And until next time, that's a wrap.
I don't know. Tell me, man, what do you know?
What do you know?
Me and my boys on the road. Where did it go? She told me, boy, you the go. Like, I don't know. But I don't know.